How you doing? Today I'll be doing a short review on the Bear River 4-inch tactical revolver. I picked this up at Walmart for $79, about $82 with tax. What caught my eye when I was in the Walmart were the bright green fiber optic sights. That's a pretty nice touch on the revolver. The two tactical rails. If you've seen some of my other videos, all these revolvers that are built like this, they look like they're from the wind gun manufacturer. And, you know, they build them for the different companies, which is Black Ops. I noticed that here on the box, they have Ignite, Black Ops. That's who made the Black Ops Exterminator revolver, and they also have the Bear River. So, I guess all of these companies go to Wingun to manufacture these revolvers. So, the companies that are included in that are the Bear River, the Ignite Black Ops revolver, the Smith & Wesson TRR-8. There's a few airsoft guns, wind gun 702 or 706. Crossman has one out. All of these revolvers that are built and shaped like this are made the same. They have the same internals, the same functions, everything, except for different logos and barrel links and the outer shape of the barrel. So keep that in mind, but I really, really like this one. I'm definitely welcomed addition to my revolver collection. Really solid, has a double, single action. Two Picatinny rails, I think, was adding this extra weight, but you know, I like it. It's balanced well, shoots well. I saw a few complaints, or heard about a few complaints about this not being too accurate. But I've had some pretty good luck at 10 feet at least. I'm going to get outside and shoot it sooner or later. Definitely have to do another video on the power. Crossman on my mind. Chronograph. I'll be chronographing this to see the power. It's claiming 410 FPS, but that's also with the 8-inch barrel by Ignite, the Black Ops Exterminator revolver that also claimed 410 on the package, but it got about 420 to 430 out of the box. So I don't know where this is at until I chronograph it. My chronograph is in storage right now. I'll be getting it soon, so just be patient, bear with me, and I'll be doing a chronograph test of this gun here. Comes with a little Allen wrench and, you know, some literature from Bear River, a couple rifles, and some other little guns they got coming out. I want to show you some shooting I was doing. First up, we got the Daisy zinc coated BBs, the 5.1 grain, seated two hand grip, and single action at 10 feet. This is the group I got, which is pretty nice. Single action, shoots well. The zinc BBs, the Daisy zinc coated BBs shoot really well in this gun. That's at 10 feet. You know, that's pretty nice for a BB gun. This is some more here. This is same thing, Daisy zinc coated BBs, 5.1 grain, seated two hand grip, and on double action shooting at 10 feet, six shots. Still pretty good group. not as good as the single action. We got one flyer here, and it's sort of spread out, you know, horizontally. I can still pretty much cover, you know, six shots with a nickel here. Oh, I got a nickel here today. This is a real nickel. And then same here for the single action. You know, I can cover that, probably cover that with a dime. And then you just got this one little guy here, still hitting the bullseye. But and then my results with the really, really popular Crossman Copperheads. Just kidding. Nobody likes the Crossman Copperheads. They're BBs, you know. I think the zinc coated a little bit more precise as far as the fit to the barrel, but you know, what are you gonna do? We got the Crossman Copperhead BBs, 5.1 grain, seated two-hand grip, double action 10 feet. We got this grouping, which is more of a horizontal, vertical grouping up and down. So you can see that definitely the zincs did a little bit better than that. And then here we have same deal, Crossman Copperheads, 10 feet seated, two-hand grip, six shots. You know, I can still, it's a single action on this one. I can pretty much cover all five shots. I have one flyer. But I'm getting, you know, I'm getting some decent accuracy. So I think the people that are having trouble with accuracy with this gun, just try, I don't know if you're shooting in single action. Single action, you definitely should get a tighter group than if you would shooting it in double action. So that might be the case. Try both. And if you're still not getting accuracy after that, you may just have to get accustomed or used to shooting and how the trigger breaks on this one. But like you said, I'm getting some good accuracy at 10 feet. I'm happy with it. And yeah, this definitely has a place in my revolver collection. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching. It's the Bear River 4-inch revolver. And it's really nice. I like it. Has the removable shells, just like all the rest of the revolvers. So yeah, pick this up at Walmart. Can order it. I know some guys from the UK say they haven't seen it or can't get it right now. Maybe you have to wait a while, or you may have to special order it or something like that. But that's it. There you have it. The Bear River 4-inch revolver. Pretty good accuracy. Thanks for watching. Hope it was helpful. See you soon.